Pressure gauges are important to help us monitor performance parameters. For example, air or water pressure is very important in water treatment because we look at how a tank operates, and tanks, pressurized tanks have air in them, so we want to gauge how much air they have. Equipment operates on pressures, how much pressure is being provided to a reverse osmosis membrane, or just working household type pressures. And we use gauges to monitor all of those indicators. Pressure gauges are used for a variety of things. We use them to gauge household pressure, if we want to see if the pressure regulator on the house is still working. We use them on a storage tank for a well system to make sure the pump is turning on and off properly. We use them on water treatment equipment, things like reverse osmosis, where pressure is a key component to the operation of that system. So a pressure gauge is used in a variety of things. Sometimes even a simple tire gauge enables us to test pressures on snow storage tanks. Pressure gauges come in a variety of calibrations. They can go from 0 to 15, or all the way from 0 to 1,000 PSI. So the trick with a pressure gauge is to make sure the application is adequate for the scale that you're using on your gauge. And then you can determine whether a pressure is too high or too low based on what parameter you're looking to operate under. Pressure gauges work in a variety of ways, from a very simple manometer style where you have a U-tube with liquid in it, and that is probably the most simplest pressure gauge. Pressure applied to either side, the water will rise one way or the other, and you can calibrate that to figure out what that pressure is. Typically we use a board-on-tube type pressure gauge in our industry, and that uses a little inside tube that's sealed, and as pressure enters the gauge, that little curved tube is going to want to try to straighten out, just like a balloon does when you start putting air into it. As that little curved tube starts to straighten, it interacts with some gears inside, which in turn moves the needle, and those are calibrated specifically for the type of pressure it's going to see. Calibrating a pressure gauge is fairly complex. Depending upon the style of gauge or the accuracy that you need to have, sometimes calibration on a periodic basis is necessary. For example, if you are in a process application where a very specific pressure has to be met, it's very important that your meter, your gauge, is calibrated to be very accurate. These gauges come in different accuracy classifications. In the water treatment industry, typically for residential or light commercial, just making sure we've got good pressure, the calibration is not quite as necessary or as frequently needed as something that requires ultimate accuracy. Pressure gauges are read by simply matching the needle to the number on the dial. A different type of pressure gauge can be digital, obviously, that gives you the number. Or in an air pressure gauge, like a tire gauge, you're just matching the number at how far the little stick sticks out of the gauge. Pressure gauges are typically come with a threaded mount that you either put it into a pipe type fitting or in some kind of a manifold. And the location of those threads is really going to be part of your installation decision. So some of the gauges come with threads on the very bottom, and this would typically be mounted to the top of a housing or in some type of plumbing configuration. Other gauges come with the threads on the very back, and this would be obviously something that you would mount like on a panel or some kind of looking at you configuration. Pressure gauges showing a negative number might have a problem. Typically, we're gauging pressures that if they're not zero, they're higher, and zero being the bottom of the scale. So if we're showing a negative number, either the gauge is malfunctioning, or we're working on a vacuum that could possibly pull that board onto into a further curve, which would make the needle go down. It could be that the meter is calibrated poorly or needs calibration. Pressure gauges provide information that allows us to monitor equipment. And if we see pressure going too far one way or the other, it could be an indication to take action that something needs to be addressed. For example, if we are monitoring pressure differential across the filter and the out or the effluent side of that filter, the pressure is dropping way low, that's a great indication that that filter is clogged up and needs to be changed. And if we don't take action, it could stop water from flowing into our house or whatever our equipment is. Conversely, pressure that reads way too high, also probably a moment to take action. Extra high pressure could result in a catastrophic failure. That's where fittings or tubing can burst, or even housings can come apart. And that is dangerous, plus it's going to leak and could result in a flood. The description of pressure differential is the variance or the delta between two pressures. So in a filter application, we have a given pressure coming in and a given pressure coming out. The difference between those two pressures is the differential. So the higher the variance, the more pressure drop that we're experiencing across that filter. Pressure gauges are great tools. They enable us to really look at how our equipment is operating, how our filters are performing, their monitoring devices. A pressure gauge is not going to create a problem, but it certainly can it could certainly give you a reason to take action. So pressure gauges are an awesome tool for us in water treatment.